Good morning, everybody. We are in what we call pre-market, and welcome to stockmarketfunding.com. We are going to be talking about what gaps are. Everybody hears the word, oh, let me go buy a book and learn how to trade gaps. Ah, throw it out the door. I'll show you the real deal. What we're going to talk about today are gap sequences. The markets are putting in a short-term bottom. Trends on the weekly charts have not changed. They have gone into what we call short-term bear trends, because they have, but we're going to talk about what gaps are. Gaps are created in pre-market by futures. And when the futures are up real big in the morning, like they are this morning, we've got futures up on NASDAQ 18, we've got Dow futures up 74, and we've got the S&P futures that are up 8 or 9. Now, one thing about gaps, there's no buyers here that created that price. It's an artificial price. What will happen on the open is that the public, like what they love to do best, is one thing, is they'll rush right in to buy it, the buyers will get right all in, and then the stocks will pull back intraday. Now, when you want to get an entry, you don't buy these opening gaps. You have to wait for about 20, 30 minutes. Sometimes you may have to wait 2 hours, but every stock will be overbought with these artificial gaps. It's not like you're in the regular trading day today and that people have just ran these things up. They're artificial, and they're created in the futures market. We've got futures markets, and another thing about artificial gaps are called roller coaster gaps. So today is the roller coaster gap up. Tomorrow, you could see when the futures are down big like they have been for the last 4 weeks on certain days in pre-market, instead of them being up, they are down in price. And there is a way that you need to learn here about what gaps really are about. And the market makers and the floor traders, once everybody gets in off of this gap, that means once the buyers get in up towards the top, that's when stocks will pull back intraday. And I'll be showing that. The trade of the week that we had featured Google as being the trade of the week on Saturday and Sunday before the stock market opened up Monday or anything else. We featured a 60-minute chart on why it would go higher, and where short-term trends change. But on these gaps, people are not disciplined. There's a wholesale entry, and the retail is this gap. That's what people buy into. And these gaps can go higher before they roll over. On a short-term trade, it's about, well, when a stock gets that artificial gap, the market makers and floor traders, once the public's in, then that's when they're going to sell short. That's when they drop $1.50, and that's when we start buying them. But you can make a profit on a quick short off of these artificial gaps. You can turn and go immediately long and come in off the bottom and be a real trader. That's what stockmarketfunding.com is about. The school is a true trading school, just like if you were on the NYSE or NASDAQ, or you were a market maker, or you were a floor trader. That's what this school is about. This is not a day trading operation, pal. If you want that stuff, go buy a bunch of books. Once you find out it doesn't work, come visit us today or call us at 702-685-0772. If you're tired of those old roads that didn't work, it's because you don't understand the inside mechanics, and there are many of them. And basically, these are the gaps for the NASDAQ. This is the NYSE, called New York Stock Exchange, and these are the gaps that are in that index. This is where 60% of your program trading happens electronically by institutional traders, and this is where a lot of your electronic trading happens. Beaten down commodity stocks are in here. RTP is up 1187. Thing is in such a downtrend, but these are volatility gaps. When you're in a bear trend on an equity and you gap up, that trend didn't change in one day. Your mind might have changed, but the trend never changed. So we got a lot of beaten down stocks. These are artificial prices in the morning. Everyone will get in, get crowded in the trade on the open, and after they get all crowded in, stocks will pull back. That's when we'll look to go long, and that's the lesson about pre-market gaps.